Put your hands up, put your hands up, come on, put your hands up.
Myth Motel 101 here, and welcome back to MCWA Justice! Well, welcome to MCWA Justice, to be precise. We have quite an eye ahead for you, fellas. And, guys, honestly, I'm not fully into it right now. Kinda just did this last minute. But we're gonna get things started with... Wait a minute. What? It seems like we're gonna hear from Tyler Watson. He isn't booked tonight. Or he hasn't been booked tonight. Well, not as of yet. But why is Watson out here? I'm certain this is going to be something that people are starting to become aware of now. Tyler Watson has recently attacked John Blackos and Edward Eller Gekurayan. After Chase put up an attack, Tyler Watson would come in to what seemed to be stop the attack. But ultimately just give both John Blackos and Edward Eller cutters. We're not sure where he calls them right now. It's probably gonna be the Revolution Cut. Not entirely sure yet, but regardless, Tyler Watson, he laid out John Blackos and Edward Eller, which gives him a strong claim going into the MCWA World Championship picture. Of course, we don't know much about what's going on with the MCWA World Championship. We know Chase has his rematch clause, but on Facebook, he recently announced that he was not going to use that rematch clause. Well, just yet, so it kind of begs the question of what's going to happen now? Watson's in the ring. Let's see what he has to say. Oh, wait, hold on. Yeah, that's N's music. Seems like he's coming out. He's not exactly taking kindly to what Watson's saying, I would think. But then again, N is Blackos' friend, so that might have something to do with it. Ouch. Should we pretend we didn't hear that? Whoa, wait a second! Seems like someone else wants to enter the fray! And that sounds like Edward Elric's music! And there is Edward Elric! Well, we obviously know that Chris thinks N is being a bit hypocritical. I won't blame him, to be honest. Well, that settles things. That seems to settle things quite easily. We're gonna have a fatal four-way match here tonight. Edward Elric, Chris Stryker, and Tyra Watson have a chance to become the number one contender for the MCWA World Heavyweight Championship. That's big news if you ask me. Of course, Watts will leave with the last word. Well, he's leaving now, so there's that statement. But still, a fail four match tonight. Yeah, all three of the others are looking at Watson. It's clear that now Watson, besides Chase, has pretty much become public enemy number one here on this brand. Gohan's pretty much been out of the equation for a while, and he's sort of a villain. But Watson, definitely public enemy number one in this area. And now we're gonna get things started with a singles match to open up the show. Chris, N, and Elric are hanging through the crowd right now. Here we have a one-on-one matchup between Gohan and Micheal Money to open up the show. Well, we'll see if Gohan even shows up. There he is. Gohan, ever since losing at Guilty Verdict to Edward Elric, he hasn't really been at the top of his game. I mean, he's lost several matches since, including a tag team match between John Blackos and Edward Elric with Zane Truesdale as his partner. But needless to say, Gohan really hasn't been on a fast track as of late. It's sort of been like he's been on the losing side of things. We'll see if he can turn his momentum around against Micheal Money. Then again, considering that this is Micheal Money, that should prove to be an easier task done than said. Yeah, I know the phrase is easier said than done, but Micheal Money hasn't won a single match here yet. And the matches that he has lost usually don't even last like 5 minutes. Which can sort of explain most men's sex lives. Yeah, I just made a sex reference here on MCWA programming. We're not TVY, TVPG. We're not that. But anyway, Micheal Money, he seems to be ready to go for this matchup. He's probably going to be ready to go out there for another 5 minutes. That guy should stop taunting Micheal Money. He has talent. One of the more technical guys on the roster. As in, well, he's pretty normal. Except he has a gimmick full of money. Gohan wins the test of strength and a toe kick. Another one. More kicks. Gohan definitely is ferocious with those kicks! Especially to the groin! Gohan's definitely at the top of his game right now. Oh! Clothesline to the legs! And now some knees to the head! Just ruthless attacks! This is where Gohan is at his best. Whenever he does some ruthless attacks... that would be banned in stuff like MMA? That's where Gohan's at his best. We saw a spine bust from Gohan, and now... knee to the gut, or stomach area. And now Gohan, into the corner! And some shoulder thrust in the corner! Now Gohan, just driving his foot into the face of Micheal Money! This matchup could already be over! Micheal Money's practically been out of it and... ka-doink! Just a kick to the head of Micheal Money! Micheal Money trying to get up! He gets up, but Gohan's been weighing on him! There's the Masenko! Masenko from Gohan!
One,
I think that's
two,
it!
Three.
Yep! No question about it! Gohan with the win over Micheal Money in a very fast matchup! I think that didn't even last 2 minutes! But yeah, Gohan definitely got the win here tonight! Back on the right track, and there's that Masenko! Wait, Eddie, guys, you forgot the replay again.
You're not even beat up one.
Oh, shut up. Anyway, Gohan's definitely happy about what happened. Hey, what's he doing with the ref? Is he trying to bully him? Wait a minute, there's Tommaso Capelli and Zane Truesdale. Well, you asked for the man, you get the man! It seems like Peter Parker's music is playing! We're definitely getting some of Peter Parker right now! Now this begs a serious question, what will he do? Alright, another poll! Sweet! Well, at least one poll. Well, that's definitely some strong news from Peter Parker. Ladies and gentlemen, we will be right back after this commercial break. And welcome back to MCWA Justice. Here we have another matchup for you guys, a singles matchup between DJC and, or Chase, and Scootaloo. This matchup was just put in. There are a few reasons for this one, actually. Well, to begin, Chase has the World Championship rematch clause. He can use it at any given time. He's opted not to use it yet, so we're going to wait on that. That begs the question as to when he's gonna use it. But right now, that's not the biggest concern, as we are focusing on the here and now. DJC's, or Chase, is not using the rematch clause, so we're not worried about that right now. However, he did get that rematch clause from Chris Stryker, albeit in a questionable manner. And who is related to Chris Stryker in some way? Well, that'd be Scootaloo. This matchup was made similarly for that reason, to be honest. But that doesn't mean that Scootaloo's not in this match without her merits. Scootaloo is participating in this match mostly for the fact to try and distract herself from other things that could go on around her. At the moment, that'd be Jeffrey Albritton. She's been trying her best to avoid Jeffrey Albritton at all costs. Which makes sense because Scootaloo isn't really wanting anything to do with Jeffrey Albritton at the moment. I mean, she could have something to do with Jeffrey Albritton, but she's kind of just been more laid back on it. I know this seems very counterintuitive to what she's done in the past, but right now, with this whole calming down demeanor that she's been portraying, she's actually went more on that route than actually going after Jeffrey Albritton. But Jeffrey is becoming a bit of a thorn on her side. So we're gonna see how this plays out for Scootaloo in the long run. Wait a minute! Well, outside I see Jeffrey Olbrin, but I also see Killer Croc! DJC and Scootaloo are surrounded! DJC tried taking advantage of the distraction. Hip toss from DJC, or Chase. Which one should I call him? DJC or Chase? Oh, Scootaloo missed the clothesline. Now Chase. Oh, this side Chase. Chase throws him. Nice elbow shot from Chase. And now going to go for a suplex. No, a stun gun. Right now, Chase is in control of this bout. And gonna go for some elbows and punches. Scoot gets out of it. There are some punches of her own. A clothesline does not take DJC down. Or Chase. There's a suplex. That Killer Croc is on the apron. And Killer Croc gets off the apron. But that gave Chase enough time to get back up. And now he's in a sleep. Now he puts in a sleeper hold. Scoot gets out of the sleeper hole and goes for a scoop slam. Now Scoot going up top. This is gonna be, oh! Missed the drop kick. Scoot's not really known to be a flyer. So for her, high risk, high reward, she's not all that. But she does want to be high risk, high reward at times. And now, oh, Oklahoma roll from Chase.
One,
there's the cover, and no! Only gets a two count. Jeffrey Olbrin and Killer Croc are just watching at this rate, just eyeing the competition. Well, Killer Croc is eyeing. Well, there's a superplex from Chase. Killer Croc is eyeing his master, and Jeffrey Olbrin is eyeing her rival, and now Scoo heads the outside. You're noticing that the referee's not starting his count! And Jeffrey Olbrin blatantly in the view! Wait, you're telling me this is not gonna be an ejection? Oh! That hurt. Wait, so we're telling me that... Hold on. This was never in the original card, guys! So, it's a no DQ match. That explains a lot. There was a pump handle slam if you want a jam from Scootaloo. But yeah, I just found out that this is a no disqualification match. So Jeffrey Olbrin and Killer Croc can actually be out here. And now Scootaloo throws Chase the outside. And now Killer Croc going to his master. Look out! That did not go well for anyone. What? Oh! DJC had enough of that psych out. And now... Well, this no DQ match basically turned into a glorified handicap match. Oh, there's a slam on the thin padding. At this rate, this match turned to a glorified handicap match. Ah! Powerbomb from Killer Croc. And now Killer Croc going for a pile driver on that thin padding. Scootaloo is almost out of it at this point. This is a glorified handicap match. Regardless of the situation, Scoot's at disadvantage, but she's still gonna fight. Because that's Scootaloo's nature. She's not one to back down. Scoot gonna run the ropes and miss the crossbody. Of course, she's a bit young, so she oftentimes mistimes stuff, so... Limit in onto the outside. I think Scootaloo, no! Albrin with the clothesline! And now assisting! Doing what he can! Famous throwing to Scootaloo! And now, Albrin, wait a minute, Scootaloo's back up! Oh, nice wheel kick! And Scootaloo goes behind Jeffrey! Scooter drive! Scooter drive from Scootaloo! Wait a minute, oh! Wheel kick! Clothesline! Man, Jeffrey's back up! And... Oh! Low blow! A blatant foul! I think Scoo's dazed a bit! Killcraft tried some... Oh, there's a clothesline to make up for that! Now Killer Croc just laying the beat down! This is a no DQ match, so... They can do this! Kinda wish I was informed in advance! Then we could've done stuff to stop this from happening! And Chase blatantly looking away from the situation! And now, wait, what is he doing? What did that referee do to you? And the referee's had enough. And Killer Croc looking at the referee, obviously intimidation tactics. DJC pulling the ref away, Topicon Pegasus. Scootaloo flies out. But now she gets in the ring, that's a grave mistake! Shoulder breaker! Getting back into that ring with Killer Croc, big mistake! And now, oh no! DJC gonna go for a vertebraker! Vertebraker on a Scootaloo! And now Jeffrey Albrighton, he's preparing to go through the crowd, as even he knows this is over! A second vertebraker! Two vertebrakers on the Scootaloo!
One, two,
and that
three.
Is it! Just sickens me that people would go to lengths like that just to get a win. Well, Chase wins this matchup against Scootaloo, but we have to give the assist to Killer Croc and Jeffrey Albrecht. There's that vertebraker. Ow! That hurt!
One!
And that's
two,
what got the win!
Three!
That got the win for Chase! Well, that's pretty blatant, but that match is coming up very shortly. Giant Gat versus Zane Truesdale. We're about to get that match right now. So, we have Zane Truesdale. Zane recently mentioned that he had some complaints with MCWA Justice, but he was more accepting of them than Gohan, Tommaso, and Tower for that matter. I mean, it seemed like Zane was willing to accept his position on the card, or his position in the company, but even he had some complaints. But now Zane Truesdale. Zane at the moment is in the Intercontinental Championship title picture. He's been put into the vote, so that means that he could very well go for the Intercontinental Championship at Cyber Insanity. If that were to happen, then he might become champion. But of course, we have to keep in mind that this isn't about the Intercontinental Championship at the moment. This is a one-on-one matchup. And here we have one half of the MCWA Justice Tag Team Champions, Johnny Gat. Johnny Gat, one-third of the Deadly Saint. Triple X has recently announced that he is an official member again. The original three Saints are back together, but Johnny Gat is the only one here tonight. Well, besides RPM if you count him, and Chris Stryker if you count him, but Chris Stryker left. Chris Stryker and his family left, and RPM's a GM. Assistant GM, to be precise. Here we go! This matchup is underway! Johnny Gat with the first dirty tactic of the match! Should we keep a dirty tactic counter for Gat? Just in case he does more stuff like this? There's a jawbreaker from Gat. And now Johnny Gat with a punch and a kick to the head. And now gonna go for a snap suplex. Johnny Gat doing actually a pretty decent job in keeping this a fair fight. Well, unless we count that whole ordeal. Oh, clothesline to the leg. And now Zane with a scoop slam. And now Zane throws Gat into the corner. Wait, oh, Johnny Gat. Oh, no, Zane counters. There's a punch to Gat. And some shoulder thrust. Now Gat's in trouble. There's a drop kick from Zane. Zane Truesdale. Zane going for a suplex.
One,
there's the cover.
Two.
Only gets a two count. Zane tries to find back and oh, Gat tried to kick. Clothesline from Zane. Zane with a stomp. A stomp to the leg. And now picking up. Oh wait, no. Oh! Nice drop kick from Gat. Now Gat's getting a little confident. I'd say he's getting a little cocky, but well, we show he's not arrogant. Oh, there's a DDT from Johnny Gat. There's
one,
the cover. One, two, and up. Only gets a two count. And right now, Johnny Gat currently in control of this bout. Wait, Zane. Oh, Zane counters and into the suplex. Zane Truesdale currently in control of this matchup. There's a headlock takedown. And a sleeper hold to capitalize on the situation. Zane holding on to it, trying to make Gat fall asleep. And now Zane. Zane's got Gat for the forward suplex. I was thinking it'd be like a suplex or maybe a brainbuster, but no, it was a forward suplex. There's a camel clutch from Zane Truesdale. Working on the head and working on the head and back. There's a punch to the head. And wait a minute. Anaconda Vice. Gat rules out. I'm surprised Zane hasn't been working on the legs as of yet. Now Gat fighting back. Going up top for the... Oh, he missed the clothesline. But at least he was able to recover. Zane with a back suplex. There's a stomp. And now a punch. And nice slam from Zane. Going for the cover.
One, two,
and no. Only gets a two count. Oh, that was countering out. Oh, wait a minute. Gat gets out of that. Zane with a back job. You could see the sweat coming from Johnny's head. And there's a pile driver. I'm no expert, but even I know that pile drivers hurt. That might be scrambling the head a little bit. Zane with a figure four leg lock. Obviously setting up for the Chimera Tech leg lock, which is his finishing maneuver, one that can put people away. Oh, a back chop again. And now Zane picks up Gath, throws him into the corner. And now Zane, belly to belly from the top. Zane gets back up. There's the cover. One, two, and no. Only gets a two count. And now, oh, wait a minute, Gat. Oh, a poke in the eye from Johnny Gat. And now Gat, going for something, no. Zane gets out of it. And now Zane looking for something, oh. Gonna try to lock in the Chimera Tech leg lock. Oh. Gat gets out of that. But that might have done some damage to the legs. Jawbreaker from Zane. And now, oh, low blow from Gat. And a jawbreaker. Cover after one, the jawbreaker. Oh, he gets a two count. Wait, Gat. Gat's pulling his legs out there. That could be a huge mistake. There's a powerbomb from Zane. Not exactly what I would have thought. But I would think Zane's working on the legs. But now he's just showing a more well-rounded moveset. Saw a release German. And now Zane going after the legs again for that figure four. Gotta set it up. That figure four is in tight. Gat may have no choice but to tap here. Sign on. No. And a clothesline to the leg. And now a Boston Crab. Zane is starting to work on those legs. It won't be long until he locks in that Chimera Tech leg lock again. Once he does, I think Gat will be in big trouble. Wait a minute. Zane got out for the Brain Buster. A Brain Buster from Zane. There's the cover. Oh, wait a minute. I think Gat barely kicked out of that. And I think Zane's starting to show a bit of aggression. There are some punches. Wait a minute. Oh, Gat gets out of that. Wait a minute. Gat, wait. Hey! Those are brass knucks! Brass knuckles from Johnny Gat! Followed by the Satro Special!
One,
Gat
two,
with the weapon! Three. And Gat wins! But I'm calling blatant foul on that. I know I'm not supposed to be biased. I'm not trying to be biased, but even I think that was a blatant foul. But obviously we're not gonna show that, are we? Yeah, we're not gonna show the brass knuck shot. But we are gonna show what won the match, the Satro Special. There it is. And one, that's what got the win for Gat.
Three.
Oh, makes me angry that Gat would win like that. Well, you guys better not go away, as that tag team match is next.
Here's to the crazy ones. The misfits. The rebels. The troublemakers. the round pegs in the square holes. The ones who see things differently. They're not fond of rules, and they have no respect for the status quo. You can quote them, disagree with them, glorify or vilify them. About the only thing you can't do is ignore them, because they change things. They push the human race forward. While some may see them as the crazy ones, we see genius. Because the people who are crazy enough to think they can change the world are the ones who do.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to MCWA Justice. Here we have a tag team match coming up for you guys. We have Emerald Flash and Peter Pan taking on Fluttershy and a mystery partner. We have no idea who this person is. It could be someone coming over from Anarchy. It could be a completely new person we have never seen. Or it could just be someone on Justice and all the surprise to be ruined. And I'm Kyle, but it's not the latter. But you never know. It's MCWA, the Mystic CAW Wrestling Alliance. We've had unexpected things happen. Not just on Justice, but throughout MCWA programming, we've had unexpected things. So I wouldn't be surprised if my prediction was completely far off, and that it's just a boring old Justice guy.
Watch it be Micheal Money again.
Anyway, Emerald Flash and Peter Pan, of course, a tag team. Emerald Flash has sort of been not doing well in singles. Neither is Peter Pan, so they kind of decided to form this tag team. Emerald Flash would take on Fluttershy and Kurayan in a losing effort. Peter Pan, so he decided Emerald Flash would challenge Fluttershy to a tag team match, see if she could actually do similar results in a tag team. Now, of course, we all know her tag team partners, so maybe they have no chemistry at all. Maybe they have all the chemistry in the world. We don't know. We'll have to wait. But as you can see, Peter Pan's currently in the ring. Sorry, I had something in there. Peter Pan, Emerald Flash, looking forward to this matchup. And here comes Fluttershy. Fluttershy, definitely one of the more technical stars that we have in the locker room on Injustice, let alone MCWA in general. Very technical and one of the few submission experts that we have in this promotion. Submission specialists are few and far between, and none are as prevalent as Fluttershy. Well, currently. But Fluttershy won with a butterfly DDT last. So we've seen that Fluttershy can win without submissions. But we'll see if she tries to lock in the butterfly lock at all in this match. Let's see her tactics corner. Whoa! Wait a minute. It's Rainbow Dash! This is a nice surprise. The former assistant general manager of Anarchy has come over to MCWA Justice, but not in a management position, but as an active star. And seems like her debut match for Justice will be teaming up with one of her closest friends. This is going to be one exciting debut for Rainbow Dash. The bell is rung. This matchup is underway. I think Emerald Flash is saying, tag in Rainbow Dash. Let's give her some action. They comply. Rainbow Dash is in the ring. We're about to get things underway. And we start things off with Emerald Flash and Rainbow Dash. Oh, There's an uppercut from Emerald. Oh, Rainbow Dash counters and out. RD, Rainbow Dash with a kick and out, going for something. No, Emerald Flash gets out of that situation. One thing I should probably mention is that both Emerald Flash and Rainbow Dash are really fast. Dash, Flash, about to be same thing. Oh, there's a chop from Rainbow Dash. But when it comes to speed, Rainbow Dash is unmatched. There's a backbreaker from Rainbow Dash. Emerald Flash gets hit with that leg drop. Rainbow Dash, currently in control of this matchup, jumps over. And an arm drag. Wait a minute. Oh, Emerald Flash gets out of that situation. Oh, nice drop kick from the run. Tags in Peter Pan. And now Peter Pan with a kick. A kick. Oh, missed the thrust kick. Wait a minute. Peter Pan from behind Rainbow Dash. And nice. Rainbow Dash able to get out of that situation. Nice drop salt from Rainbow Dash. Full with a chop to the corner. Rainbow Dash runs over. Splash. And no. Peter Pan gets out of that scenario. Rainbow Dash currently in a tough situation. But she rolls out. Fluttershy is watching, giving support with some class, not getting on the ropes like some people would. Now Rainbow Dash with a few kicks, trying to stun Peter Pan's legs. Nice snap suplex. And now, oh, into the corner. Oh, knee strike missed. Peter Pan with a tornado DDT. And now Peter Pan going to tag in Emerald Flash. Emerald, and there's a tag to Fluttershy. So this is the first we're going to see a Fluttershy in this matchup. Fluttershy goes behind Emerald. No! Gets, Peter Pan got out of that suplex predicament. Now Fluttershy, snap suplex. And now there's the cover. One, only gets a one count. And now, oh. Fluttershy's got Emerald. Oh! Tried going for a neck breaker, it would seem. But that got countered. Emerald Flash currently back in control. And, oh! Fluttershy is
one.
Outside and out.
Two.
Emerald, look out!
Three.
Shooting Star Placha!
Four. Five.
That
six.
Has got to hurt!
Seven.
Emerald Flash throws Rainbow
eight.
Dash into the ring. Rainbow Dash
nine.
Is not the legal person.
Ten.
And now Emerald Flash gets back in the ring. Wait, Rainbow Dash is in the ring. She's not supposed to be. Snap suplex for Emerald Flash. And now Emerald's got Fluttershy. There's a few jabs. And a gut wrench. Gut wrench suplex from Emerald Flash. And now, oh, Fluttershy gets out of the predicament. Drop kick to the leg. And now, going for an arm bar. Emerald Flash rolls out. And Peter Pan misses the target entirely. Not exactly what you want to do. And now, oh, drop kick missed. And now, Fluttershy. Oh, wait, inside cradle, small package.
Whoa.
Only gets a one count. And now Emerald with a kick. Arm drag. Emerald Flash right now currently doing a really good job in this matchup. Wait a minute, Fluttershy. Fluttershy with the crucifix.
One.
And that was not a rope break. I kind of questioned that call. But it really didn't impact the match. Had it impacted the match, I definitely will have considered that a possible call. I will consider that maybe a dangerous call. There was an enziguri from Emerald. Wait, Emerald Flash going up top. He could be looking for the... No! He decided to go for a knee drop. Wait, Emerald... Oh, a drop cell taking Rainbow Dash off the apron. And now there's a tag. And now they're gonna go for a double team. Wait a minute, there was no tag. Oh, there's a double team from Peter Pan and Emerald Flash. There's the cover after the double team. Only gets a two count. And oh, nice. A kick from Fluttershy. Now Fluttershy going for the cross arm breaker.
Break.
Too close to the ropes. Wait a minute. Oh, nice. Wheel kick from Fluttershy. There's the tag. And now, oh. That somehow caught Emerald Flash. And now, oh, nice kick. Rainbow Dash going up top. And, oh, nice. Flipping clothesline. Followed by a Rolling Thunder. And now, Rainbow Dash. DDT! Rainbow Dash taking the momentum back. Way Emerald Flash is back up. Into the corner they go. There's a tag to Peter Pan. Peter Pan. Oh. Low blow! That hurt a man. Peter Pan. Gonna try to keep up the momentum. Wait a minute. Oh! That's a crossbody! Only gets a one count. Emerald Flash was there to break it up. So that's sort of a relief for Peter Pan. Wait a minute, going for a famous sir? No! Rainbow Dash had that move scouted. Nice! Oh! Oh, nice! That was innovative. Wait a minute, oh! Wait a minute, Rainbow Dash! Rainbow Dash! Sonic Rainboom! The Sonic Rainboom! And oh! That did not. Wait a minute! That was a psych out!
One!
A very innovative psych out, if you ask me. And now Rainbow Dash up top! 450 splash!
One, two!
There's the cover, and Emerald Flash gets in just in the nick of time! There's that speed that I was mentioning! And a kick to the head of Emerald Flash! Rainbow Dash gonna tag in Fluttershy! She's gonna let Fluttershy do the work! Butterfly DDT! That's what she used last time! Wait a minute. Oh! Wait a minute. Fluttershy goes behind Emerald! Wait a minute. Look out!
Three.
Butterfly suplex on the outside! And there's the cover on the Peter Pan! Who's likely out!
Three.
That's it! Peter Pan was out of it thanks to that Butterfly DDT! And Fluttershy and Rainbow Dash pick up a tag team victory. This could set them one step closer to the MCWA Tag Team Championships. Or Justice, anyway. We're gonna see a replay. There's that Butterfly DDT! Guys, where's the replay thing again? You missed it. Oh, yeah. Oh! And then Fluttershy would go out and then hit a Butterfly Suplex on the outside.
Four.
Then Fluttershy would quickly get back in the ring and then go for the cover to get this win.
One,
ladies and gentlemen, our main event's coming up, but it's gonna have to be after this quick commercial break.
There are no strings.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for our main event of the evening. It is a fatal four-way matchup that we found out about earlier tonight. Tyler Watson and Chris Stryker and Edward Elric. They are competing in a fatal four-way match to determine the number one contender for the MCWA World Heavyweight Championship at Cyber Insanity. This is big because practically anything can happen here. We could see quite a bit of interesting matchups, some that have already happened. But I am interested to see what the main event for Cyber Insanity will be, at least on the Justice side. Tyler Watson making his way to the ring now. He's sort of the one that started all of this. He attacked John Blacko and Edward Elric in Kuraan. Then he said earlier tonight that he was tired of being in the backseat. He wanted to move up. And now he's definitely done just that. And he's garnered a lot of attention for it from quite a bit of guys, not just in the locker room, but on social media. Watson's definitely going to be the big... He is public enemy number one at this point. I mentioned that earlier tonight. Of course, the first one to mention that N was not doing things... Well, that Watson was not doing things correctly was indeed N. And N, well, he stated that he didn't exactly like what Watson was doing. And it's pretty obvious. And I respect N for that. Because Justice is not really the place where you just do all these sneak attacks to hope and get momentum. In fact, a good majority of the guys that have been at the top of the card have been in the scene for so long, have been the guys that have been at the top here on Justice have been the ones that have been respectable. Very few guys who I know of were just cowards and decided to just move up that way. But of course it didn't stop the fact that this guy, Chris Stryker, would call N pretty much a hypocrite. Chris pretty much called out N and saying that N would do the exact same thing if he was in Watson's shoes. Now, of course, N denies this, but that's something to think about. Maybe anyone in Watson's situation would do it. It's definitely an interesting conflict. On one hand, you say, I need to get up ahead somehow. Then you have, like, I want to do it in the respectful way. It kind of just goes back and forth. But the fact that Chris Stryker called N a hypocrite? Yeah. You'd never really think of that. I mean, I wouldn't think of N to do something like that, but maybe he would. Who knows? Of course, we cannot forget the fourth guy in the mix. Edward Elric. Now, Edward Elric would come out to confront Watson. And it led to quite a bit of debate. It led to the fact that N is signed with Elric and Chris technically might be signing with Watson on this. I don't know. But we're going to see which one of these four become the number one contender for the MCWA World Championship at Cyber Insanity. But bear in mind, afterwards, we have to figure out what would the match type be. And we'd have to give it out as a fan vote. So that's something to think about. And with Edward Elric, Watson, Blackos, and Chris involved in the mix. Well, Blackhouse is technically not involved in this confrontation. We're not sure what he's gonna do, to be honest. But it's a serious question. What will happen? Who will become the number one contender? We're gonna find out now. This matchup's underway. Elric obviously looking at Watson. Watson looking at N. Chris is looking at N. And it's kind of a jumbled mess. Wait, oh! Dropkick. Oh, nice suplex from N. And now Chris picking up Elric. And now, oh, nice power slam from Chris. Doesn't even get a one count. Right now, oh, Watson gets up. Oh, that kick was blocked. And now, Now N with a rib breaker. That can hurt. There's an arm bar and a cross arm breaker. Two submission holds. And now, Elric, nope, Chris goes behind. And looking for something, no. N picks up Watson, and now N going for a headlock takedown. And now, oh wait a minute, oh! Nicely done. Wait, now N goes after Chris and throws Chris the outside. Wait a minute, Edward Elric dives out into N. This leaves Watson alone in the ring, and now he's going around. There are DQs in these matchups. Unless they get otherwise. Watson, but wait a minute, Chris goes behind Elric for the backbreaker, and now Watson, oh, try for something there, no, and end with some punches. Elric's back up, and now into the barricade. End and Watson are just staring down, and now Elric going to, wait a minute, oh, pile driver. Now Watson, with a bulldog onto Elric. Right now, Watson. Now, oh wait a minute. Ends back up, Watson's down, Chris is up. Wait a minute, oh, that was countered. And now, oh, nice rolling kick from Watson. And now, oh, nice clothesline. Wait a minute, oh, Russia leg sweep. Full metal leg sweep. Wait, and goes behind Elric. This will end bad for someone. There's a sleeper hole locked in. Oh! And just flies to the ground with that drop kick. There's a backbreaker. Oh! That did not end well. And now, Watson. Oh, that was countered. Oh, nice kick from Watson. Now, bear in mind, a good majority of this match has been on the outside in that particular area. Wait, N. The match is starting to spread out. There's an arm bar or cross arm breaker. And, oh. Oh. There's another confrontation on the other side. Wait a minute. Edward Elric. Pump handle slam if you want to jam. And there's the punches from Elric. Oh, nice rolling kick. Now Edward Elric going for some more punches. At this point, Edward Elric's just going for the punches. And, oh, nice kick from Watson. And now, this matchup is starting to spread out. Edward Elric and Chris are on one side. Watson and N are in front of the ring. Wait a minute, now. N with a painful-looking submission hold. That is gonna hurt. And now, oh, Edward Elric with a sit-out powerbomb. No pinfalls on the outside. Edward Elric just kept it on for a while. Probably just as a bragging thing, I don't know. Pile driver from N, and There's a recliner on the outside! And now, oh! Now Watson, oh! Watson with the headlock! Now Watson has N! Oh! I think he tried to throw him into the post, but... didn't exactly work out. Watson missed the knee. Oh! Chris is just standing there, looking over Elric, and now going for some punches! And now... I don't think that's gonna work. Now Watson and N are nearby, Chris and Elric again! Wait a minute, Watson goes after Chris! Into the barricade goes Chris! And now... Backbreaker! Wait, Elric's back up! Elric! With another sit-out powerbomb! And holds on to it again! Wait a minute, Chris! Nightmare on 6th Street! Or Nightmare on 3rd Street, I'm not sure what it is, to be honest. There's a recliner! Elric, let's go, and... what's he doing? Oh, he's going for some more punches, and Chris going for some punches! And they're both gonna go back to their targets! Simultaneously punching! Just more punches! We had them in stereo for a bit, but now not so much! But I don't think we need him in stereo to understand that N and Watson are getting a beating! Just punches like crazy! Like, if I tried doing a whole punchity thing like I would usually do in a situation like this, it'd probably not work out at all! Wait a minute! Oh! Reverse modified neckbreaker from Chris Stryker! Kind of like a reverse twist of fate! Oh! And now, oh wait a minute, there's that submission hold again! Modified neckbreaker there from Tyra Watson, that may be a side effect, I'm not entirely sure, but... now Watson throws N back in the ring, we're finally gonna get action back in the ring! Wait a minute, backslide on the outside! Doesn't even get a one count because no pinfalls on the outside. Wait now, Elric! Elric and Chris are back in the ring! N is still out! There's that... I guess you could call it... well, it is a side effect as the name, but... obviously people are complaining for using that as the... stuff like that as the name. Even though it might be paying homage. There's some knees to the head of N, and now Chris has got Elric up! And now, pump driver from Chris! There's a kick, and oh, blow on the end! Oh, a kick to the head of Chris! And now, oh! That does not bode well! Wait, Chris! Go around the ropes! Oh! Guillotine! Wait, oh, and with the... low clothesline! And now! Oh, kick missed! Wait a minute, oh! And goes behind Watson! Elbow! Now all of them are standing up again! Elric just watching! Chris is just staying there, Elric going to... Elric looking at Watson. Wait a minute. Watson. Gonna decide something and now... wait a minute! Why did the bell ring? Wait, what? The match has just been called off? What? You couldn't call it off like 5 minutes ago when they were on the outside, but no! You said... gah!
You guys are so insecure!
Wait a minute, is big news. Cyber Insanity, a four-way vote to decide the number one contender. And now, Elric and Watson WCW, wait a minute, they both went for cutters. Sudden alchemy and a cutter from Watson. Now Watson, wait, Elric, Watson with the cutter. And Watson again with the upper hand in this situation. Watson stands tall for now, but will he once Cyber Insanity rolls around? Ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys for watching Justice. This is Miss Montone 101, signing out. Peace!